Hey gang, welcome to Jay Plays World of Final Fantasy. I'm excited. For some reason. Let's start.
World of Final Fantasy.
Let's hear that again.
Huh? Oh, right. World of Final Fantasy.
Let's see if we can get someone we recognize.
World of Final Fantasy.
Maybe. Maybe not.
Huh? Oh, right.
I already heard that.
World of Final Fantasy.
Okay, it doesn't over, right?
World of Final Fantasy.
Maybe?
World of Final Fantasy.
Yuna. Definitely Yuna. I've already set up all my config to be what I need it to be, so let's go. New game. Oh. Creating a save. Demo version clear data has been found. Claim your bonus. Tell us, yeah, I'll claim my bonus. A Colosseum ticket. For Magitek armor. Cool.
Prologue. Awake at last.
Tick tock, tick. Tick tock, tick tock, tick tock.
The brother. The sister. Upskirt. That's a fucked up place to wake up.
Time to wake up.
Dead. Video game system is that? PS1?
Huh. Oh, right. I gotta get to work.
I like that Moogle with the sunglasses on.
Oh, am I gonna make it? The boss hates when I'm late. Then again, it's not like business has picked up any.
fuck going where they want me to go. I do what I want. Okay, so we have a Chocobo, a Cactar, and Kate Sith. There's the Moogle. There's the PlayStation. What's this carpet? Is it just a carpet? So it's called the Twins Room. There's clearly just one bed. Oh, what's going on up here though? Is that... I thought maybe there was like Squall's jacket. I guess not. I like he just keeps his hand in his pocket. Too cool for school. Alright. Nothing going on in the twins' room, I guess.
Maybe we should start selling sandwiches along with the coffee.
So you're a coffee shop that just sells coffee? Seems like a recipe for failing business. Okay, it won't let me go over there. Map.
The streets sure are quiet today.
Yeah, you could say that.
Hey, I'm here.
Huh? How'd she get in if no one's here yet?
Good morning. I'm real sorry. I hope you haven't been waiting long.
The customer.
Oh, right. She needs some water.
Oh, no thanks. A pint. I mean, a cup of coffee, please. Oh. And bring the whole jar of sugar. I'm gonna need it.
Right. That's one cup of joe. And I'll get you one of the big jars. Has nobody made the coffee yet? Come on. Get it together, guys. I'm sorry, miss. This might take a while.
Hey, no hurry. Time's not an issue.
They have muffins.
Here you go.
Thank you.
Sure.
One cube, two cubes, three cubes, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 13 cubes of sugar.
There you are! Oh. Mon!
Keep it down, Rain. How about acting your age, huh?
Dramatic
hey,
pose.
Don't talk down to me. Listen. Last time I checked, little bro, I've been around a few minutes longer than you.
Okay. I get it already.
Very sorry.
Rain and lawn.
So what's up? I'm all ears.
Well, you don't have to get all sarcastic. You really are all ears.
What?
Forget it. Solon, have you seen anybody this morning?
Well, yeah, I mean, I'm looking right at you, aren't I? And there's that customer.
What?
Ah! Oh, hello!
You didn't even see her? Dude.
Yeah, but... Ah! Look! Come with me right now!
Easy!
There's nobody here!
So, it's a quiet morning. Maybe they just...
I mean no one!
Huh?
Lon, have you bumped into anyone today, besides her?
Now that you mention it, I guess not.
And this isn't setting off any alarms?
Well, should it?
You two really don't remember a thing. Huh? What was that? Who are you? If you're from around town, then I don't know you.
Rain Manners.
You two really don't remember a thing. Would you please just answer my question? You can call me Anna Crow. Anna Crow will work.
Anna Crow.
Okay, well, we woke up to a ghost town this morning. Maybe you know why?
Yes, you're quite alone. But you always have been.
Huh?
This world, it's always been the two of you. A world without time. One that ended when it began.
What? That's the weirdest thing I've heard.
But don't worry. Just because the world ended doesn't mean that it's going anywhere.
You know, I have been checking up on you two.
Until now, you were nothing but blank stares. So imagine my surprise when Lon took my order. What a morning.
Okay. Now you're kind of scaring me.
So, now that you're awake, we've got a story to tell. Which brings us to...
Tama! Right to here!
Who the honk put this thing on my head?
Yeah, I did try to mention it before.
You take it from here. I'll go on ahead and link up a path.
You the got it!
Huh? Hey! You can't just leave!
Salutations! The name is Tama, and I'm the here to help out. Does anyone have any questions?
Huh. Wait, I've got tons of questions! Why were you sitting on my head? And how the hell can a fox even talk?
That's the seriously the first thing on your mind? Now I see why Anna Crow is just about the ready to throw in the towel.
You're not allowed to be confused!
Hey, whoa, take it easy there, Lon.
I thought you were upset,
Let's
too!
Let's start the over. I'll make us some of the coffee.
Huh? Oh, yes, please.
But I already made some coffee before you got here. How can you just roll with this rain?
Chill the owl. You live the much longer.
Yeah, Lon. You shouldn't start out your morning with so much stress.
Oh, would you like some sugar?
3 cubes for you, right, Lon?
Huh?
I'm good with just one.
No.
Okay, I'll have to go and put the coffee on.
But I just said I... You know what? Just give me my dang cup of coffee.
Ooh, off to a rough start so far.
Me and Rain?
That's the correct. Those the marks on your arms are proof. You were born to work the miracles.
Miracles? Our arms can... do that?
Dude.
How could you forget? You used to command a whole legion of them. You were masters of them. Powerful living illusions known as mirages. In the fact, even the Pleiad answered to you, and those are the 7 strongest mirages of all. With their power, you could have the ruled over all the world.
Oh. So, we could have ruled the world? Because, what, we controlled these mirages?
Well, that's what I've heard.
From who?
What do you mean? In a crow that told me, of course. But enough the reminiscing. I've got to teach you two to use mirages again.
What? How's that?
First off, I'm going to present you with my very own Prismarium.
So what does it do?
With this Prismarium, the mirage inside becomes yours. And you can then make it do the anything and the everything you command. So let's then try it right now in glorious combat.
Wait. What? Huh?
I choose you. Thing, whatever you're, Maya? Is this name Maya?
Throw some attacks out there. To take action, you need to spend something called action points, also known as AP. You automatically gain a little bit of AP each the time your turn comes around in battle. The amount of AP you need depends on the what you're trying to do, so make this sure you use them wisely.
Get ready, it's battle time. Characters take turns based on agility. The faster a character, the sooner they get to act. See that long, thin bar? Each face represents a different character. When a character's icon reaches the top of the bar, they can select an action to perform. You can use R to switch between characters who are ready to act. I'm not using that method, so I don't need to have shortcuts. Yeah, so... that's the shortcut one, which I'm not going to use. Unprismable. Does not like poison. Sleep. I assume that's blind. Is resistant to death, maybe? Okay. No abilities.
Yeah, that's the way to do it!
Certain commands like magic and other abilities cost AP to use. Characters recover AP when their turn comes around by successfully exploiting enemy weaknesses. The more powerful the command, the more AP it requires. Most mirages have weaknesses you can exploit for bonus damage AP. Discovering them will give you a huge advantage, so don't be afraid to try things out. Alright, let's see what this thing does. Attacks. Foxfire.
Abracadabra!
Active and wait. Active, semi, and wait. I'm going with wait. Here's another tip. Use the classic menu, which is what I'm using. Is all but dead.
Not for one to tussle.
GG. Oh, don't get to level up. All right. Okay, 7 gil.
The figure it out yet? The two of you? We're undersurpassed. No, the Mirage could stand up to you.
Dude, seriously?
Dude, this seriously.
It's hard to believe.
I'm sure it is. As far as I can tell, you two have lost everything. All the memories and experience you've ever accumulated. Oh, but wait. Of course that would have happened when you and this world were spliced out.
Huh? So not only did they lose the Mirages they had, they've been stripped of all their memories of the Mirages too? But I guess that explains why all their other memories seem to be largely unaffected.
What? Listen, let me show you something. There, just beyond this light, lies another world called Grimoire. That is where you'll find all the Mirages you've lost.
You mean they're all inside this gate?
You got it. Are you ready to conquer them again?
So, if we do manage to find all the lost Mirages, does that mean we'll be able to remember the things we forgot?
Well, I don't know about that. After all, you lost your memories. It's not the same thing as forgetting them.
Oh.
But, even if you don't remember Grimoire, Grimoire still knows a lot about you. You're certain to find traces and records of your past.
Okay. So, like...
You're saying, whether we remember anything about ourselves or not, we can still find clues about our past and the things we've done?
Correct. And if you keep on gathering Mirages, I think you might even meet your family in due time.
Our family?
Huh? Well, I guess... It does make sense that we'd have parents.
Oh, yes. So then, you going? You going? Will you journey to Grimoire?
The plot of this game and the voice acting so far is pretty fail. I'm gonna save. I got a trophy. It's already.
Chapter 1. Land of the Lilikin.
Wellspring Woods.
So, this must be Grimoire. What?
What? You look like such a little dweeb!
Oh, I know! We look ridiculous!
Huh? Oh, don't worry! I'm sure that's how everybody in this world must look. Inna Crow just wanted to make sure you had a nice and a handy way of blending in.
Wow, she can do stuff like that?
That is awesomely weird.
Well, this kind of works out. We won't have anybody gawking at our arms.
Way to find the silver lining.
In Grimoire, the smaller people are called Lilikin, and the taller people are called Giants. The twins can switch freely between these forms, L1 in circle, L1 in square. Although you're free to stroll around as either size, you will start combat in your current form, so it's never a bad idea to have the stacks set up for both situations. Okay. Tapping the tip jar. The tips you see in these panels are never out of reach. You can view them again by selecting the tip jar from the game's menu. In fact, you might even notice that Necros has slipped a few extra tidbits in there that don't appear during the course of the game, so remember to check the jar every now and then.
I guess we should head straight down this path?
It's the only direction we can go. Think you can manage to not get lost? You know, just this once?
What? I'm not gonna get lost. Yet.
Items. I don't have any. I have the Yaguru Prism. And I have Colosseum tickets. That's from playing the demo. I can get Magitek Armor P. What do I have in the tip jar? Active time battle, assigning shortcuts, battle modes, classic battle menu, action points. Tip jar, little kid and giants. Okay. Okay. It won't let me do stacks yet. Oh, look at that little chocobo chick.
Oh, hello. I spy another mirage.
That is the call to Choco Chick. What are you the waiting for? Go on and imprison the it.
Okay.
Okay. Bam! Oh, I can fast forward. Sweet. Let's go, Tama.
First, you're going to need this.
It looks sort of like a prismarium. What is it?
That's the call to prism. Use it to make the Choco Chicks prismarium. Every time you find a new of the mirage you haven't seen before, it'll be recorded in Enna Crow's special mirage manual.
Whoa! Does it even have pictures?
You the betcha. And whenever you add a new mirage to the manual, you receive one of its prisms. But only the first time, mind you. Okay, first, try the weakening the Choco Chick, then they use your prism.
In order to imprison a mirage, you'll need to empty an empty prism compatible with that mirage. But there's some good news. Enna Crow will reply to you with your first compatible prism whenever you encounter a new mirage. Huh? Why is Enna Crow just folk order with a whole lot of them right now? Come on, where's the fun in that? Besides, she doesn't do bulk orders. Don't worry. You'll be able to befriend almost every mirage you meet, eventually. Be sure to take the time to get to know the friends you have before looking for new ones. All about prismariums. Once a prism holds a mirage, it's known as a prismarium. A mirage's prismarium allows you to use the mirage in battle. If you look closely at a prismarium, you can see a miniature world inside. Okay. I guess. I like snow globes. So be nice and don't shake them. So to recap, you start with an empty prism. Imprisoning a mirage in the prism turns it into a prismarium. The prismarium lets you add the mirage to your stacks and use it in battle. Even if you fail to imprison a mirage, you won't lose the prism, so there's no need to hold back. Good luck. Alright, cool. So they're not consumables. If you press options during a battle, a window will open containing info on the mirages you are facing. And with the Libra ability, you can even see even more detail. Okay, so options during a battle, and then Libra also. Strong and weak to different elements, just the standard elements. It was blind and deaf, not bad. Nullify and absorb. So nullify is like bouncing off of, and absorb is like a vagina. Element status and element symbols. In addition to status elements, characters sometimes undergo other positive and negative changes. In battle, these are usually triggered by abilities and sometimes represented by the following symbols. Stun, regen, haste, protect and shell, brave, fade, reflect, KO. Strength up and down, magic up and down, accuracy up and down, defense, magic, evasion up and down.
Not done yet!
Oh, they're doing Libra on their own. Cool. Uses physical attacks to create a prism tunity. I get it now. Opportunity. Requires a Choco Chick prism. Doesn't like blizzard or dark. Stuff. What was that? I don't know. Press options. Okay. Good to know. Press the options button. Good to know. She has no abilities yet. So she will... It didn't tell me... What did it tell me? Damage? It was damage, right? Damage to get... Use physical attacks, right? So...
There! A prism tunity! Use the Prism command to claim that mirage for your own. Go on! The Selectian Prism command! You might have to try different things before certain mirages will let down their guard and they give you a chance to imprison them. Think the outside of the box.
You can't just walk up to mirages and imprison them. To collect a mirage, you need to knock it into Prism Tunity state first. Mirages won't let their guard down forever, so don't miss a Prism Tunity when it arrives. Sometimes all you need to create a Prism Tunity is a big, heavy club. But the brute force approach doesn't always work. Try putting the club down and thinking outside the box. Prism Tunity requirements vary from mirage to mirage, but Libra can often provide you with a good hint.
Chick is inside the Prismarium. It's yours to the keep.
Victory!
And they leveled, and she should level too. Sweet. She's only 5 XP behind. No Gil. A little Chocobo that loves to waddle around. These feathery friends love to headbutt things. This is fine because a Chocobo's eggshell never cracks twice. Growth ratings. Agility. So Choco Chick probably turns into Choco Bo and then something else? Gold Chocobo maybe? Use the default. Choco Chick it is.
Cool! I can see the Choco Chick running around in the Prismarium.
Pretty the neat, huh? Next, why the don't you have a go at stacking that Choco Chick on your head? Here, watch. I'll just show you.
Oh, now I get it. So when I saw you perched on Lon's head back in Ninewood Hills, that's what you call stacking.
Yep, that's the right. While I'm up to here, I get to take it nice and easy.
Is that stacking or slacking?
When you create a stack, the HP of everyone in the stack gets the added together. Like they say, strength in the numbers.
Oh, so it's like combining into a super robot.
Better than yet, your magic and other abilities have the potential to change too. It all depends on how your stack is configured.
Huh? Oh, I don't need any action figures when I get to blast out super attacks like a super robot.
Well, just be the careful. Stacking doesn't make you invincible. Some of the enemy attacks have the power to unstack you.
In other words, bye-bye super robot, so to speak.
Yowzers. That does sound like bad news.
It's true that we are individually the weaker when we're unstacked, but look on the bright side. Since we each get our own the turn in battle, we can use the extra moves to have one member attack and another the heal. It can be very the helpful. Depending on the situation, you might even decide to unstack yourselves by choice. Think the carefully and choose the best setup for the job.
When you stack with mirages, the stats such as HP of all the stacks members are combined. Your abilities may also transform. Stacking with the right buddy can give you access to new and powerful skills and magic. You're always more powerful in a stack than you are fighting apart, but there is one downside. Weaknesses are also shared among the whole stack, which can get you into trouble. Use the stack setup screen in the game menu to choose which mirages fight alongside you, or is it on top of you? You should also set up stacks for both your forms, Lilikin and Giant. That way, you're ready for battle no matter what size you're using to explore. Stack can be up to 3 members high. There's one simple rule. Smaller goes on top of bigger. Try it out and you'll get the hang of it in no time. Lan, Rain, and their mirages are assigned sizes, small, medium, and large. In your stacks, large goes on the bottom, medium goes in the middle, and S goes on top. Small goes on top. Easy, right? When Rain and Lan are L-sized giants, mirages will always stack above them. But when the twins are M-sized, Lilikin. Things get a little more crazy. Suddenly they can ride on top of large-sized mirages and put a small-sized mirage on top of their heads. At the same time!
By the way, you two can just switch between giant size and Lilikin size. Depending on your size, you can make different stacks. You won't be allowed to put big things on top of the small things when creating a stack. So, to get on top of a mirage, you need to be in Lilikin form. The best way to learn is to try it once you've rounded up a few more mirages. You'll pick it up in no time.
Game repeats itself. Abilities. How we'll roll for the moment. Fucking tip jar.
There's nowhere else to go. What are we gonna do?
Never the fear! Look the closely! This may appear to be a wall, but it's actually a gimme golem.
Is this a mirage too?
Not in the traditional sense of the word. But you'll see these pests all over Grimoire. And unless you give them what they want, they'll give you a hard time and block the way.
So what is it they want?
It really depends on the gimme golem. So the first thing you'll have to do is examine it. Gimme!
A luster leaf.
So where do we find that?
That choco chick you just imprisoned ought to be able to track the down what we need. But first things the first, you're going to have to unlock the right ability on the choco chick's the mirage board.
Using mirage boards to power up. Each mirage has its own mirage board, a special chart that's packed with new powers and potential, abilities, stat boosts. Each space on the board holds a new surprise. You can unlock the spaces using the skill points your mirages earn when they level up. Some spaces on the mirage boards cannot be unlocked until you meet special conditions, but with a little work, they're all within reach. Support ability Stroll. Mirages that have learned Stroll ability will appear alongside Rain and land in the field, so you can explore Grimoire together. If you are accompanied by multiple mirages with the Stroll ability, you can cycle between them left and right. Sometimes strolling mirages will discover useful items. Try bringing different mirages to different places. You might be surprised what they find. Chick has 3 SP. Alright, let's see. Restore Cure, which is 4, which you can't buy. And Ram, inflict neutral physical damage. I guess we'll go with that. Learn Ram. So now he can learn a blank space or Cure. Knows Foxfire and Libra. Slightly raise HP. Slightly raise Strength. Slightly raise Accuracy. HP, Strength, Accuracy. I don't think the game is going to challenge me too hard right now, so we'll go with Strength instead of HP. And then I can learn Magic. Or critical.
Hey, the Choco Chicks come along for a stroll.
Huh?
That took a second.
Yay! Yuda found it! Now, try examining the Gimme Golem one more at a time.
Huh? It found something.
Gimme, gimme!
Whoa! It vanished!
That's so cool. I guess the Choco Chick found us just the item we needed.
Yep, yep! With the help of a Mirage of the Two, there's nothing that you can't accomplish. And Mirage Boards are for much the more than unlocking abilities. You can also use them to change your Mirages into new and the powerful forms. So be sure to keep on the leveling up and working on your Mirage Boards. Pretty soon, you'll be bouncing and the trouncing across Brimmoor like a pair of the pros.
You gonna find anything else, Choco Chick? I mean, there is nothing else.
Mirages disappear when we defeat them. Why is that?
Most of the Mirages you see in Grimmoor don't actually technically belong in this world. And so, when one of you guys gives them the old KO, they can't maintain their presence here anymore. They fizzle that out and go back to their own world.
Huh.
Wait. Now, that's weird. Who was it that told me all this before? Ugh. It's like, right there, on the tip of my tongue.
Now what's this?
This is the called a Merc Rift. Inside you're the likely to find Mirages that are, shall we
Mirages?
Say...
Oh man, let's go catch them!
But...
This one's not very cute.
Merc Rifts, scary but true. Merc Rifts are home to strange, rare, and usually very dangerous mirages. If you want to explore one, make sure that you're fully prepared before diving in. Most Merc Rifts will be too tough for you to handle when you first find them. If you do end up getting whopped, come back later after you've gotten a bit stronger.
Vaughn! Why did you... Now what do we do?
I tried to tell you. Inside Merc Rifts, you're likely to find mirages that are the strong and dangerous.
You tried to tell us. Try a little harder, please.
Time to fight. Unprismable, and it tells me nothing about its stats. It doesn't like dark. It resists everything. Okay. Four damage. Wrecked.
No escape.
There is no escape. Wrecked. The party has fallen. Game over.
Oh no. Did you two die already?
What? I died? But that's... no way!
Maybe it's true. That mirage in the Murkriff did kinda...
Well, I'm still alive.
Yes. That's because someone intervened. Right at the moment of your demise. And made it so the battle never happened.
Wow, you can really do that?
Of course. Although Tom is the one who does it.
That's the right! I have the power to rewind time a little. And then to whisk you to safety. Although, it costs me a life to do it, so I hope you don't mind if I rest for a little the while afterwards.
A life?
You might not believe it, but I've actually got multiple lives. Back there, I had to sacrifice one of those lives to turn back time and to save you. You see, this girl with the ribbon that showed up in my dreams, she's the one who taught me how to do it.
That makes zero sense and kind of freaks me out, but Tama, I'm impressed.
But thanks! Oh, but just so you know, I can only use my powers to protect the two of you specifically. And only if you lose a fight, like what happened to you in the Murkrift. And I can always recover my lives if you stay here and let me rest a spell. So, don't forget to give me a breather before I run out of second the chances.
Dude, you got it. Say no more. Rest yourself silly.
Yes, sir.
Thanks, Tama. We really owe you one. Especially Lon, who didn't have the good sense to listen before diving in.
When the entire party is defeated, Tama will whisk everyone back to the safety of Ninewood Hills. There is no penalty, but you have to fight your way back to where you were. Be careful, though, if you're inside the threshold of a powerful mirage, Tama won't be able to save you. It's game over.
Hey, who's that?
Oh, if you mean our new guest, she claims to have gotten herself lost. Go say hello. She's quite the character.
Okay.
The real question is how she got here from the outside world when it's no easy trick. She must have experience crossing between planes.
Yeah, we'll save. Did I save? Yes, whatever. I have no idea if that saved or not.
You're the only ones who can decide what your future holds, so don't ever forget that. So, she's over at North Promenade.
Okay, so I kind of have an idea where... how this town works. It just told me to visit the twins room, so I'll visit the twins room.
Need something, Lon? Need something, Lon?
Oh, the Mirage Manual is a PlayStation 1. Pages of 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. 210 Mirages in the game. Four, six, eight, ten. 70 who's who characters. Or a bit less. Mini games. I don't have any unlocked. Well, alright.
If the one of your mirages has learned the stroll ability, that will follow you around in the field, just as the llamas you included in your lineup. Speaking of the witch, I have that ability too. So if you always the want your adorable Tama at your side, keep me in your lineup, okay?
I had the Chocobo chick, I guess, doesn't follow you here. He was following me on the last screen. Not on this screen.
Oh, wow. She's so tiny. Is she a... what's the word again? Lilikin?
Chocobo Golina! Oh! Hello, and how are you?
Good. More or less.
You know, what a nice, quiet place.
So who are the you?
Oh, you can call me Chocolatte!
Still hot.
I seem to have washed up here like a soggy yellow feather in a storm.
Huh?
I do have this funny knack for winding up in strange places.
Cool.
All right! Care to shop? I've got the goods! Chocoboco cheese!
Chocolatte has a habit of picking all sorts of strange items. These items can be yours if you're ready to fork over enough of Grimoire's currency, which is known as Gil. Chocolatte Mart's selection is always improving, so when you visit Nine Will Hoods, don't miss the opportunity to stop by and see what's in stock. Potion, Phoenix Down, Antidote Eye Drops, Remembers, removes Oblivion. Pick Me Up, removes Sleep, Smelling Salts, Wobble Stopper, completely stabilizes the stack. Sometimes inflicts Poison, Sleep, Confusion, Blindness. Berserk, Lethian Chime? I like the Chocobo song playing.
Whoa, slow down! What kind of operation is this?
It's called a shop, dear! You're in luck! I find all kinds of stuff as I bounce from point A to point Q. I'm your Chocobo connection!
So, hey, are you ready to head back to Grimoire?
My stack, just not strolling with me for some reason.
Shoulder yourself, Serapy! I didn't know it was you!
You had it coming. You know, when you awakened, you should have woke me up too. I don't remember raising you to be such a selfish selfer poo.
Who's this?
Oh, hi. I'm just your adorable local wind pixie, aka Seraphie. My hobbies include gossip mongering and, let's see. Oh, I'm good at hoarding things. Yep.
Hoarding?
Hoarding. Why do you think I'm here? You must have tons of prismariums, more than you can handle, right?
Well, we're still working on it.
Uh-huh. You'll have scads of them before long. You're gonna need a place to unload.
Yeah, they are kind of bulky.
Well, who's got you covered? This pixie right here. Enicrow made me a special prism case that lets me keep all your prismariums safe. Just plonk the ones you don't need in and yoink the ones you do need out. All plonking and yoinking must be performed within the confines of Nine Wood Hills or from an alternate location with a suitably strong connection. Additional terms, conditions, and restrictions may apply.
Okay.
I'm not sure I caught every single word, but I guess I agree?
Oh, yeah. This Prismarian belongs to one of my tribe. Treat it with the same boundless love and affection you feel for me.
Okay.
Seraphie's kind of a special the case.
Anacross has entrusted Seraphie with a prism case that automatically stores all Prismariums you collect. You can use it to select which mirages you take with you on your adventures. The prism case is also where you are permitted to transfigure mirages. Talk about a handy contraption. Seraphie keeps the prism case in Ninewood Hills. You can access it by talking to her directly, but the case is also at your disposal in Grimoire. Just select it from the menu at Gates or Save Crystals. A Seraphone. The Seraphone is a special device you can use to call Seraphie and access your prism case remotely. Seraphie is not too keen on leaving Ninewood Hills, but thanks to the Seraphone, you can still swap mirages while on the go. Just keep in mind that each Seraphone can only be used once because Seraphie doesn't feel like getting off her because your data security is important, of course. Sylph. A tiny wind pixie that makes its home in forests and other places of natural beauty. Sylphs are good friends of Seraphie. In fact, she sometimes meets up with them to play card games and gossip. So be sure to treat them with the same balanced affection Seraphie expects you to feel for her. Wow, pretty susceptible. Once per battle, reduce the Mirage's HP to create a Prism Tunity. Oh shit. Oh, that's if I'm trying to catch one. Stack on him. I can't. So it's Tamar or Seraph? Or the Sylph? Well, I guess I'll keep Tamar. And the Chocobo chick. I guess.
Anyway. I think you should be able to manage on your own from here.
You mean you're the leaving us?
Yes. You handle things now.
Oh, okay. Either will.
It's cool. I'll lock this place down tighter than a Marlboro's bottle of mouthwash. That's a Seraphie guarantee.
Huh? It down.
But where are you going now? Oh, well. Somewhere
what
else,
do you
of
mean?
Course. Yeah, that's not exactly very helpful. Look, we really need to ask you so many things.
No, you'll figure it out. I can't do everything for you now.
Everything?
But you've barely done anything. Besides, every world has its own rules. Like water dousing fire, and light banishing darkness.
I think that's just called science?
Well, I designed mine to be so completely unbreakable that even I can't undo them.
Undo what?
The rules.
You're bad at explaining.
You're saying you can't help... Because yeah, that violates the rules
dude.
Of the world or something?
Have fun
exactly.
Tomba.
But why is that?
Yeah, it is.
I mean, come
cute,
on.
But I think
just
it's kind
who do you
fun.
Think you are?
Me? Oh, well. I'm God.
Hasta la vista.
She's gone.
Dude.
I guess we can't necessarily rule it out, but for somebody calling the cosmic shots, she seems kind of sub-benevolent.
Well, That's Anna Krell for you, so get used to it.
So, she really is God?
Beats me. Anna Krell is Anna Krell, wouldn't you say?
Pretty the much.
Thanks for clearing it up.
Are you the impatient type, or is the funnel a trick? During cutscenes, hold R1 to speed through the conversation. Not good enough for you, then you can always press options and skip the scene. Of course, if you start skipping scenes with Abandon, it won't be long before you have zero idea what's going on in the story. But then again, if this is your second trip through Grimoire, you may want to get right down to business. You've always got the adventure log to fall back on. Yeah, we'll save. Alright, they restore HP and AP. Good to know. Okay, usually no combat. Place I can go. Change characters with R1.
Well, that certainly cost us a chunk of time.
And whose fault is that?
Oh, yeah, I want names.
Random encounters! Oh, it's a little thing. R1 to speed up battle. Auto battle. Oh, snap. Okay, he'll just do what I told him to do last time. Physical attack. Still no gill. A cute little forest animal, or at least that's what it wants you to think. Then pow! A tail punch to the jaw. This mirage has nothing to do with the legendary continent. May or may not squeak moo when upset. You earn in battle split between all participating members. Mirages that are accompanying you but didn't fight in the battle receive flat 8% of total XP earned. However, mirages in your prism case get nothing, so make sure to bring mirages along with you if you're trying to make them stronger. Good to know. Circle check? Yeah, find that thing again. A potion? Bad.
Alrighty, let's go.
Come on, bring it.
Greens. Angil is what I'm talking about. So I'm probably still not strong enough.
Yeah, we got this.
I guess we're doing this.
Auto?
All right.
Predictable. Lon, don't touch it this time.
I know. But could we see all this stuff before?
Once, you can see all its information. And if you happen to know some Libra magic, you can peep at its data before you even jump in. Very good thing to keep in the mind.
Got it.
Yep, very good thing to keep in the mind, Lon.
Why are you repeating it? And just for my sake?
Nobody likes you, Lon, that's why. Sylph levels up. Got a potion. Looks like Cloud. It's Magitek armor. Everybody, the whole gang, Lightning, they're all coming to help wreck.
Chapter 2. Foretold by Prophecy.
I hope we're almost out of the woods. I'd say we're out of the woods.
Hey, sis, is that a town over there at the end of the bridge?
Yeah, and I don't know why, but something about it takes me back.
On the locomotive, and the head of the locomotive is a cactuar head. Amazing.
So, you think we're supposed to get on?
Absolutely. All the aboard.
Whoa, dude.
Oh, okay. Just forced me to get on the train.
Oh, hey, sis. Let's park it here.
Sure.
A white mage and a black mage.
Hi.
Whoa! Pluck my needles. I don't know how long it's been since we've had new passengers.
Huh? Sid?
Right. Tickets, please.
Cactuar conductor.
A mirage?
What? It talks?
Oh, I indeedly needly am a mirage. But I'm also the train conductor, so... Tickets, please.
The conductor? All right. If Tama can talk, then why not?
But the train tickets that we need
are right here.
Right the hell?
Wow. Semi-lifetime passes, eh? Haven't feasted my eyes on one of these in a swell spell. Right then. Pleasant journey.
Where did those tickets come from?
In the Chromage, sure. I was provided with everything we could ever need. Yep.
Okay, then.
So why a semi-lifetime pass? And not a lifetime one?
Fish. There was a fish on that character's head. And that cat. Amazing. Just a fish flopping around. Cornelia? Well, that's Final Fantasy 1. And we kind of have some Final Fantasy 1 music.
This place rules!
Yeah, it's like something right out of a fantasy.
Hey, Tama, why don't you hitch a ride?
Roger the Dodger!
Pardon.
Huh?
If I may ask, would you be kind enough to tell me what country you hail from?
Oh, us? We're,
Mirage is from the Mahamushin Army!
Bahamu? What's a Bahamu?
Well, the Bahamutian Federation has a whole army of mirages in their employ.
Huh? Someone's made a whole army out of them?
Sounds just fine by me. Line them up nice and neat for us, so we can round them up.
Huh?
Hey, wait up! Lon!
I'm gonna be tiny. I don't wanna be tiny.
All right, you Bahamus. What's your beef, huh?
You have to make it sound like they're made of beef.
Yeah, Lon. Don't you know what's at stake?
Terrible.
how you like this. You're done!
What? It won't tell me to crit what I have to do? And what a piss off. Tell me what I need to do to catch him.
Just happened. Why wasn't I able to imprison that mirage?
Didn't you see the light that's surrounding it? That means it's the beholden to another keeper.
The what? B.O.? They smell?
No! What I mean is, the mirage already has another the master. So until you give their boss the old heave the hoe, you won't be able to claim it for yourself.
Some mirages already belong to another master. Okay, the red glow. I missed it. If you look carefully, you can see chains holding their souls captive. Oh, dangling from up. I totally didn't see any of that. Can't be imprisoned, no matter how hard you try. Defeating a mirage's master will break its chains, allowing it to imprison it. The problem, of course, is finding the master.
Oh, fire whoever wrote that little hook in.
Come on, ixnay on the fourth wall stuff!
Giants.
Oh, whoops.
Are they Bahamutian soldiers?
But they drove the mirages off for us.
It's just like the prophecy, word for word.
But which one?
Well, we know how it ends.
Please, may I speak with you?
Huh?
Sure. The two of you. You've traveled here from another world.
Oh, well... I wouldn't... I mean...
Actually, I think you're pretty much spot on. And we're Mirage Keepers, too.
Run! Don't tell her!
Why not? Face it, we're too awesome to try and hide it. I'm, like, exuding all over.
Mon, you don't even know what exude means.
There is someone who would like to have a word with you. Could you possibly stop by Castle Cornelia?
So let's find this Casa Cornelius place. Doesn't Casa mean up? It's gotta be higher up.
Now, quit racing about before you trip and break your neck.
That woman must be important if she's inviting us to the castle.
If we cooperated with other powerful countries, those Federation goons... Come to think of it, our neighbors in Saronia also stand against the Federation. Then again, if we joined forces with another country, we'd just become even more obvious targets. Makes it tough for the princess to reach out. I wonder if there aren't any powerful countries or organizations out there that we could ask for help.
I knew it! So giants really can make themselves big or small whenever they want! If I became a giant, could I make myself big or small too?
To marvel at the princess's stubbornness. After all, joining the Federation would guarantee her kingdom's safety and prosperity. Of course, you won't catch me going along with the Federation either. That's the whole reason I left my hometown to come here. You have to marvel at... Of course, you...
Hey, White Mage.
Many people who stand opposed to the Federation have abandoned their hometowns and fled here to Cornelia. Do you think that could be the reason that the Bahamutian army has become so much more aggressive lately?
Oh. You know what I can't wrap my head around? There are actually people out there who've agreed to go along with those Federation tyrants. I don't know why anyone even trusts what they have to say. Right. We should stop by.
Castle Cornelia is up near the top of the town.
Oh, okay. Right. We should stop by.
And talk to that one guy.
You see, the Bahamutian soldiers are all giants like you.
I've been around for quite a long time, but I've never in my life seen a giant who wasn't part of the Bahamutian army.
Right, tickets, please!
What's up, guys? Nice armor.
Leave them alone, please.
Thank you for coming. Welcome to the Kingdom of Cornelia. I am Princess Sarah.
Wait, you're like a princess?
We had no idea. Oh my gosh. I am so sorry Lon acted like such a royal idiot.
I'm not royal.
Oh, and I'm his older sister, Rain. It's an honor.
Please forgive the ruse. At first I suspected that you might be agents sent here by Bahamut. I was wrong. You stood up bravely against their mirages, and kept our town safe. All of Cornelia thanks you.
Oh, I wouldn't say we were that brave. Really.
Stop, you're so modest. Still, the fact of the matter is, we didn't do anything all that outstanding.
Yeah, we're more the instanding types.
Huh? I'm pretty sure that instanding isn't in actual the word.
Forgive me. It's just so hard to believe that you two are the stuff of prophecies.
Prophecies? Oh, that's right. I think I heard the townsfolk going on about some kind of prophecy, too.
Oh, I am sorry. If you will permit me, I will explain it from the beginning. You see, Cornelia is an unfederated state midway up Grimoire.
Unfederated?
Yes. Let me explain that as well. The majority of Grimoire's countries and municipalities have annexed themselves to the Bahamutian Federation under the rule of Brandalus, the Herald King. Cornelia, however, has continued to maintain its sovereignty. The Federation has made attempts to erode this stance countless times. But we have held our ground, and now Bahamut has taken to armed provocation.
You mean like that mirage attack before?
Yes.
So where does this prophecy factor in?
The Azure Prophecy speaks of a divergence. When time begins its march anew, they shall return as visitors. Giants from the hills of a world not our own.
So that's how the end upon Grimoire, start of Final Fantasy
they will
wreak happen.
Two divergent futures.
That
one that brings salvation,
that painting
and
at
the other
top. Not
ruin,
painting, but
an enigma to confound even the highest mind.
Stained glass?
The giants may wreak two futures?
Wreak, huh?
Oh, man! Tama, this prophecy's about you!
What are you even talking about? There's nothing wrong with the way I smell! You big the dummy!
Well, at least I'm dumber than you!
I'm sorry, Your Highness. I'm afraid there's just no hope for them. Oh. So, the giants from the hills, as in Ninewood Hills? I guess it's one of those believe-what-you-want-to things, but yeah, so far, it does seem to match up.
Do you mind if I ask you a slightly awkward question? If this Federation is really so terrible, why have so many countries agreed to become members?
Most of the Mirages in Grimoire, not all, but certainly most of them, are now firmly under the Federation's control. With such a powerful army behind them, citizens can go about their lives without fearing the Mirages that still roam free.
Dude, they control that many Mirages? Seriously?
Yes! Dude.
Whoa.
King Brandalus's Herald Lieutenants, known as Siguardus and Pelinor, command all of Grimoire's Mirages with the same authority as the famous Queen of the Keepers of ages past.
So there was a Queen of the Keepers? Sounds like she was pretty powerful.
Yes, but that was more than a century ago.
So, sorry for the string of dumb questions, but if the Federation can guarantee that kind of absolute protection, wouldn't it be worthwhile to take them up on their offer?
It may seem wise, but you see, membership in the Federation involves following their laws and adoption of a heinous creed. It chills me, right to the marrow of my bones.
That bad?
Yes. I beg you, see for yourselves. Once you have done so, well, you will understand.
All right, then.
Now then, may I ask what the two of you intend to do next?
Well, whatever's going on out there, the only thing we can do right now is just keep rounding up more Mirages, am I right?
Oh?
Apparently. At one time, we commanded a whole legion of them. But somehow, we lost them along with our memories. So, we're hoping by getting the Mirages back, we might stumble on some clues about our past.
That's right. So if Mirages like those goblins are bugging you, we can lay down the smack.
Lay down the what?
I think what he's trying to say is we'll help you out, or at least in the best way we know how.
Oh, wonderful. You have my thanks. Mine and all Cornelia's.
Still, if we're going to be any help, don't you think we need to beef up our arsenal first? Because we can't put up much of a fight without some strong Mirages.
Good point. Princess, do you know of any nearby places where strong Mirages live?
Certainly. If you travel to the northeast of Cornelia, you'll find the Nether Nebula, a network of caverns inhabited by many wild Mirages.
Ooh, nice.
Well, not at all. Savage Mirages have been sighted in the nebula. You may well end up dead.
That's cool.
If you insist upon going, then please take the utmost caution.
He will, Your Highness. Otherwise, he's gonna be extremely sorry!
Wait a minute, why just me? What did I do?
Save again.
It looks like we'll need to wind our way down to reach the exit.
Seems that way. What a funny way to build a town.
Oh, it's not that strange to the people of Grimoire. Hey, while we're here, why don't we ask around town and to see what we can find out?
So the giants from the hills weren't just a legend after all. Wowzers! That would mean, according to the prophecy... who cares about prophecies? The important thing is, wowzers!
What am I gonna do? Oh, say, you wouldn't happen to be the giants from the hills by any chance, would you? You see, there's a situation I'm dealing with where I could really use your assistance, since you must know Mirage so well. Could I trouble you to please bring me an earth hammer? If you could, I would be forever in your debt.
I'll take quests, why not?
Thank you again for...
You know what, I can't...
Huh? What's this thing?
Oh! I was hoping a path might link thee up here!
Hey, Tama!
Wait up!
Huh?
Hmm? We're back in Ninewood Hills?
You see, the gate here doesn't connect to just one, the area. All throughout Grimoire, you'll find places. Save the locations that lead back here. Open the way to come and the go as you please.
And how exactly do we do that?
You already the saw. Just walk up to the right place, and that's all it takes.
But surely a means of transportation that handy must come with a catch?
No, the catch! You can use the gate as the little or much as you like. What's more, time in here and time in Grimoire, they don't both flow at the same speed. So whatever crisis is going to down, you can put it on hold and kick back here till you're ready.
Wow, it's like magic!
Yeah, really irresponsible magic.
Just imagine revisiting any place we've been! Call it the Super Porta Park!
Are you the kidding? That name definitely gets an F.
He deserves an H.
An H? But grades only go down to F!
Extra, extra. Read all about it.
What do you the one here, Serapy?
In case you're wondering, you can use the prism case anywhere you find one of these gates.
Oh, I think I get it now. Gates are the what you meant when you talked about a strong connection.
Huh? Oh, right, right. That's the gist of it.
Throughout Grimoire, you'll find shining gates like the ones you see here. Approaching the gate will connect it to the main gate in Ninewood Hills. Once it's linked up, you can use the gate to travel anywhere you've already been. Exit gates are special one-way doors for leaving dungeons, so they're not accessible from the main gate. As you progress through the story, a chronicle of your travels is recorded in the game's adventure log. If you haven't dropped by Grimoire in a while, this is a great way to catch up. Select mini ventures to have a peek at quests and errands you've undertaken. Naturally, you can stop by and check your progress, but you can also collect quest rewards here too.
Okay, to the Nether Nebula.
I still don't know what this does. What? There's more? Changing leaders. What? There's more? Thank you.
Did you know that train is used to carry wood from the forest? Not only that, mages in training use it all the time, too.
If you get poisoned in battle, the toxins will gradually drain your HP. Make sure you deal with poison early by using an antidote. Here, this one's for you.
What's that? Thanks, random guy giving me drugs.
Chapter 3. Old Acquaintances.
Pressing the touch button brings up a map. Helps you get your bearings, also lists your destination, location of gates and safe crystals, even includes a list of mirages you've discovered nearby. You can unlock each map as soon as you enter an area.
She said the Nether Nebula is somewhere northeast of Cornelia.
Time to go hustle and rustle a little mirage muscle.
Just don't hustle so much that you get yourself lost, okay? I might just leave you there.
When's the last time I got...
Don't push it.
Okay. Wow, the air here is so clean.
Yeah. A Yahoo!
Wait, no, Rain, you need to shout for it to work. Yahoo!
I don't want to go that way. God damn, this game. Alright. Don't tease me like that. Oh, it's my first dungeon.
Be the careful. The mirages in here are a lot the stronger than any you faced the before.
Yeah, let's not mess around in the Never Nebba thinganabob.
Nether Nebula. Do you think you can do something about that habit of forgetting the name of virtually everything?
Oh, here's another gate.
That's the right. Gates that usually turn up in towns or at the start of most mirage-infested areas. You never have to travel far to visit a place you've been. Whenever you want to get from point A to point B, just use the gate as a handy little shortcut.
A shortcut, huh?
So, like, if we wanted to go back to Cornelia right this instant, we could just take this gate back to Ninewood Hills... Then we can take the gate from there to Cornelia. You see? All in all, it makes for a pretty short shortcut.
Yeah! If it were hair, you'd have to call it... You'd have to call it a buzz cut!
Okay.
I think Lon is, like, autistic. Or he has Asperger's or something. Libra Mirror Jewel. Mirror Jewels are made by extracting your Mirage's abilities and crystallizing them into gemstones that impart those same abilities to Rain and Lon. As the twins fulfill certain conditions, like raising their levels, they'll unlock more Mirror Jewel slots. Eventually, they'll be able to equip up to 8 Mirror Jewels apiece. Oh, cool. So I can get rid of the one that has Libra. They gain the abilities temporarily when they equip the jewels. If you've got a stack you like, but just need one more piece to unlock a more powerful ability, mirror jewels are going to make up the difference. You can unlock mirror jewels on the Mirage Board and find them in the treasure. I get it.
Man, I love a good adventure.
Get in a fight.
Let's make this good.
Dude, it's on.
Attacks.
Trouble at all.
All right.
Mirage, it looks like someone stapled a set of arms and legs to a head. Blake's charging his enemies while singing Go Go Gollum Body Slam. But seriously, who doesn't?
Just behave yourself.
So she'll get Libra because she doesn't have it. So now she does. And that's good to know. Why are you... Who's got cure? Nobody? None of my people have cure? I really thought someone had, and I don't have any mediums, so I'm just gonna keep the stack I have now, I guess. I might... Well, we'll see. Let's just keep going.
Alrighty, let...
This dungeon is way more dungeony than I thought.
Did you know that originally, dungeon referred to the biggest tower in a castle? It's what they called the castle keep.
How long has it been since I've heard Rain go off on one of her educational rants? She must be pretty upset.
Then why is that?
Dak too?
Yep, you're not the only ones who get way the stronger when you're piled up.
Do their abilities change when they're stacked to them?
Afraid is so. Which means somebody needs to stop underestimating the enemy but to his neck and some...
Okay.
At least he knows the warning's meant for him.
Go!
Cool. Caught one of those. Gotta knock that stack over.
There!
Okay, full heals. Oh, I missed.
Yeah,
good job.
Copper gnome. Wait, what? Composed almost entirely of copper, this metal. With the metal, takes pride in its tough hide. It is incredibly satisfying to face one of these and shout, Mia, see, you'll never take me alive, copper. If you get that reference, then congratulations, you are old. Call me old, I guess. And it's a medium, so we can stack them. Mandagoras live all over the world. These little guys may look cute, but don't touch. They're poisonous. So while no one's ever cited one of the process one in the process of growing, you can never be too safe. So if you see two floppy leaves sticking up, be smart and don't yank them.
You know where the word trivia comes from?
Sis, I think we're good.
Choco Chick, can you learn anything? No. Learn a custom ability. But you want Cure. So we'll hold out. And Agora, 3. Stroll. Inflict wind damage, topple strength low, raise accuracy. Might as well learn that, and I guess that. Slays HP, accuracy. Throw stone. Protect. And alright, versus double smash. Hits twice. That seems pretty good. I guess I got everybody, and I guess I'll use another potion. Okay. Come on. Sleek Stone. What are you? Gimme Golem wants a Sleep Stone. Okay, there's a Gimme Golem right there. Hey, everybody again, levels. Now, the question is, am I still poisoned? I don't think so. potion back. Fuck, I did this the wrong way. Alright, gotta cycle back through the dungeon.
We've got the advantage.
You won't know what hit you. Trouble at all.
Oh, right.
Alright, cool. More levels. I wonder if he... My... Only has 3 SP. Double smash. I need 1 more SP. Get that double smash. Three potions. Cool. The wrong thing. Damn it. Alright, they've been rocked. Oh no, I didn't want to do that again. Alright. Okay, it's fine.
That was a good fight.
I forgot they redo the last ability.
For.
It's a strange switch that the response to mirages. The mirages you imprisoned the inside these caves should be able to help you out.
Puzzle switches like the one you see here respond to mirages you stack on top of them. You'll need to use mirages with the right combined weight and elemental resistance to solve them. Once you do, the switches will trigger changes in the environment and help you proceed. Most switches can be solved using mirages that lurk nearby, so if you find yourself stuck, try hunting around the same dungeon for new mirages. Gotta catch him up.
Check out that switchcraft.
Yep. Now we know
switch way to the go.
So whichever one of you thinks you're being clever is about to get a knuckle sand switch.
Ugh. Did I just get owned?
I'm the raising the white flag here, too.
I hate puns. And this game is so full of shitty puns. I'm gonna cry. Okay. Do I wanna do this first? I don't know where I... Oh, okay. It told me on the left what my weight is. Got it.
It's on.
Let's make this good.
Okay, we got some enemies here. Let's get the eagle first. Miss! You shit. Alright. Thanks, at least she crit. Oh, they're trying to knock it over. Oh no, I dazed. I don't know what that's gonna do to me. Gonna fuck me up. Okay. I almost lost that fight. Potion. Okay. You should be out of days. Oh, but they're gonna topple. They're gonna topple. How do you miss again? You shit. Magikora. It's hurt. So close to toppling. Missing a little. And they're gonna topple. Oh, they missed. Okay. You want to defend? No, wrong people defended. You want to defend. Stop from toppling. And you want to attack. You want to. We're doing better. Bringing the fight back. Okay, they're very close. Okay, they toppled. Stack that easily. Okay.
Take this!
Alright, prison. There it is. Cool. We caught him.
Well, that ought to do it.
Predictable.
Medium one is the question now. Oh man, levels for everybody. It is a medium. A winged eyeball that slings magic. Pro tip for keeping yourself awake at night. Try to visualize its heart and brain gas splurshing around in there. Ultimate focus. What that means. one more thing left to go. Earth Hammer, needed. And a Phoenix Down. Alright, quest complete.
Hey, Tama. Weird question. How come all this really useful,
Gil Blaze.
Oh, it. That? I guess Inna Crow is the trying to give you some tips.
Dude, really? And here I thought I was some kind of super genius coming up with all the answers on my own.
I hate to break it to you, but you will never be that person.
I know. It's so sad.
Whoa, hey now, come on. You don't have to look that brokenhearted when you say it.
Moderate amount of earth damage. Control, even if they're not in my stack. That's good to learn. 5 SP, yo, Choco Chick. Choco Chick. Pure. Hells yeah. Increased amount of gil. Raise defense. Blank space. Hells yeah, cure. That's what I want. Golem, you learning anything, buddy? Strength, yeah, that's a really good one. Learn that. You have 4. Learn punch. No, what do you got for me? Detect, accuracy, double smash. Yeah, that's what we want. 5 SP, okay, what do we got here? HP, accuracy, magic, I don't use magic, critical. HP, I guess. Cure. Yeah, cure will come in handy. Next. Sleep. Fly rain and land a short distance. So their little shit hop maybe becomes a bit better. Maybe. Is that everybody? Yeah, that's everybody. Okay, so now abilities. Choco check. Use. So it doesn't have any AP. If I get into a fight before the save point, which I didn't.
Oh, what's this?
Oh, that's not the good. This is the call to threshold. Mirages that create them to mark their territory. When you see a threshold, you better watch out, because the mirages inside are extremely the powerful. And the worst part, if you cross it and lose a fight the inside, I can't use my powers to rewind time and extricate you.
No extrication? Guess we'd better be extra careful then.
Ugh. Anyway, it sounds like if we're going in, we better go in fully prepared.
That's the for sure! And don't forget to save your progress, too.
Alright. Sounds like a boss fight. They can create thresholds. Tama can't rescue Rain and Lan from defeat while inside an enemy threshold, but it's simply losing a battle against these powerful enemies equals instant game over. Remember to save your game and get prepared before entering the threshold. Another thing to note, powerful mirages bind themselves to their thresholds, which means that a mirage inside its own threshold can't be imprisoned. However, defeating a mirage will cause its threshold to shatter, so next time you encounter it, you might be able to imprison it. Not happy with a button shortcuts to see in battle, select abilities, acquire abilities. Yeah. I don't want to use shortcuts. Okay, to the boss fight.
What the honk?
Be careful!
I expected some foolhardy adventurer with a terminal case of curiosity.
Ramu?
What's this?
Ifrit? Or Ifrit?
Well, look who's back.
And Shiva.
Ah, the Half-Pints. Hail and well-met.
Hail and well-met?
That's not our names!
I think he just means hello. Oh, and for the record, he happens to be a half-wit and a half-pint.
You haven't changed a bit.
Huh? What's so funny?
Oh, you're having a lawn moment. Guess I'll just add this one to the pile.
Wait, what pile? There's a pile?
Apparently, we've met the three of you before, although we don't remember it.
You do not remember us?
Really? No wonder they haven't summoned us.
Then our course of action is clear. We must ensure the pecking order is pecking in the right order. If you seek to command the three of us again, then demonstrate your strength now or else be destroyed!
Hold now. Why must you two always let the blood rush to your head?
What do you mean?
Would you just look at them? These are not the Mirage Keepers we knew.
Hi.
You're right. They do look rather... How do I put it?
Put what?
Lan does set the bar low.
Like Limbo the bar low.
Huh? Ah, I see.
See what?
Very well. What say we pit them against just one of us, to keep things nice and fair?
Agreed then. Go on. Choose from among us, and choose wisely.
Choose for what?
Time certainly has not made you any more clever.
What we're trying to say is, the two of you are no match for all three of us at once. Which means...
Right, I get it. Thanks. Now... Let's see.
Huh? Wait, get what?
I've got fire magic. And I've got earth magic. I have more earth magic than I do fire magic, so I'm gonna fight Ramu. And I'm not gonna use the hammer.
Could be foolhardy to challenge me.
For a quest.
My judgment bolt strikes with such force it would shatter your very soul.
Watch it. For an old guy, he looks pretty tough.
Dude, tough doesn't even begin to describe it.
Be the careful. Remember, we're still the inside their threshold.
Okay. 2000. He doesn't like Earth. He resists everything. But earth and dark. Earth and dark. Earth and dark. Channel earth.
Come on! You're mine!
2200 to go. Okay, he didn't hit very hard. Channel earth.
Done!
1900 to go. Well, I'm just gonna keep hitting him with Earth.
That all you got? Watch this!
1600. Okay, we're doing all right.
Next.
1400, 1100, 800, or maybe 700 at this point.
That all you got?
400.
I was hoping to let off a few sparks. Judgment! Hold!
Is that all you got, old man? You're fucked.
Nice.
Here goes!
One more. Alright, this should do it.
Come on! Come on!
Yeah.
We did it!
Woo! First boss fight. Check. An Arma gem. Cool.
Enough. I have seen my fill for one day.
That was fun for what it was.
A shame the two of you have so much growing up to do.
Quiet, you! I'm a Hulk waiting to happen.
So long. We shall meet again.
Well, our paths may cross before you know it.
Bye-bye for now.
Huh? What's this?
A prismarium, duh.
I know it's a prismarium, dummy.
You didn't manage to imprison those tough mirages, but it looks like they gave you this prismarium from the same tribe as a consolation prize.
I see. I guess we made the grade then.
Zapped. A wired tyke who's still learning to absorb lightning. His magic set remains limited. Don't confuse them with a certain colored mage. They're two different things. So, not a black mage. So, Judgment Bolt was like Ramu, and then I guess Heaven's Wrath is an even stronger Ramu? Transfiguration, or transfigging, is the act of changing into a more powerful mirage or changing back again. A mirage gets to keep all space it is unlocked in its mirage board. This means, for example, that a choco chick you transfigure into a chocobo yourself will potentially be more powerful than a chocobo you imprison in the wild. A mirage can transfig into any form and size you've unlocked, but there's one catch. You can only do this from the prism case. If you're not anywhere near a gate or save crystal, you can call Seraphie with a seraphone to access the case. Just so you know, some mirages have unique abilities that aren't shared between transfigured forms. A perfect example would be Tama's secret weapon, the Super Fox Dimensional Tama Beam. Does not actually exist. Wait, but what if the Tama Beam did exist? Is that what you want? A sidekick with eye lasers? Eye lasers that would eradicate all foes? Eye lasers that would burn her cute little retinas? Eye lasers that would be exceedingly painful? Shame on you for wishing that. Let's look into getting Tama a tail laser instead.
The mirages of the nebula have been set free. And once again, time resumes its march.
Was that a carbuncle?
Well, we better make our way back to Cornelia before the Bahamutians get any funny ideas.
We gotta go all the way back.
You can head to Ninewood Hills right now if you want to.
Huh?
Now that the boss has been the bested, I can make you an exit gate right here and now. Ta-da-da! It'll take you the back to Ninewood Hills, and from there, Cornelia's easy.
Thanks to the buzz cut. I remember.
You don't get shortcuts much the shorter than a buzz cut. Wait! Unless you buzz the buzz cut, and then the what have you got?
I think at that point, you call it a bald cut.
This game is killing me.
Whenever you want to rest up and recover HP.
While we're there, we should stop by Chocolates and stock up on items.
Hey, you got it.
Turn in that hammer. Finish that quest.
Chapter 4.
No!
A legendary
warrior. The Warrior of Light is not what I wanted.
Okay then, let's check in with Princess Sarah.
It's the Bahamutian army!
What? You're here already?
Fuck him up.
Rain! Mom!
Perfect timing! We were actually just on our way to see you.
If they've established a camp near our gates, then clearly they must intend to finish us once and for all.
So what now?
Seems to me we're going to have to nip this little problem in the butt.
Hmm? What do you propose we do?
We should take the fight to them.
Well said, but as things stand, Cornelia simply does not have the manpower.
If you can just buy us some time, we'll do the rest.
Huh?
Me and Rain will sneak up on their boss and take him out.
What? Is it really that simple?
Well, he may not exactly look it, but Lon's pretty good in a fight. thing is, he used to get picked on for being such a pipsqueak.
Please, as if you were ever any taller than me.
Oh, well, I might have made up the pipsqueak part, but he definitely did get picked on. I think that maybe the other kids were a little creeped out by our arms. Still, we were always kind of proud that we looked like this, because it meant we were just like our mom, right?
I guess.
So, let's talk more about Long getting picked on. Boy, did they make him cry. But, after I whipped him into shape, he never lost a fight again.
Wonderful.
But that's not because he turned into some kind of bully-destroying machine. He just literally never picked a fight he couldn't win. Really? His threat assessment skills were uncanny. He always knew the odds. Call it natural cowardice.
Hey, watch it.
Solon, how about it? Do you think we can beat those guys?
Piece of cake? Well, not a piece of cake. More like a very large sliver of cake.
Well, there you have it. So, are you willing to trust us?
Very well, then. We must act. It is only a matter of time before the Federation completely overruns Cornelia. We will fight and place our faith in the Mirage Keepers.
Huh. What a weird thing to remember. I know someone bullied Lon, but why can't I remember who?
Oh my god, please. All right. Where is he? Dude.
The goblins haven't made any moves against us.
Quest.
We finished evacuating the town. We tried to convince the princess.
Well, that's a piss off. Where's my quest?
Hello there. Are you the keepers from the prophecy? I'm Captain of the Cornelian Army 1st Brigade. Princess Sarah has appointed us as vanguard.
Brigade Captain sounds a lot like Snow.
We have been informed of the particulars. We'll time our feint to when the two of you storm the field. You can set out just as soon as you're ready.
Collect these and good things might happen. Okay. Oh my god, it's such annoying. Beware the thresholds. I know. Alright.
They're specialty items made by isolating a Mirage's abilities. If either the one of you equips them, you'll be able to wield whatever the abilities they hold. The right Mirajules with the right Bastak can make for a powerful combination.
Morning, noon, and brunch. I'm there with a Choco smile. Welcome to the Chocolate Mart.
a lot of money for stuff I don't really want to use. I have two antidotes. Nope, not gonna use them.
Thank you!
And they suggested I go back to my room, so I will, but I don't think it'll do anything.
That face! Oh, I hate walking everywhere. I can read you like a book.
Huh? Me?
Yeah. I know a lazy slacker when I see one.
Hey!
What's up?
Oh, just some news you may find of interest. It'll blow your little minds. Why? Because you will never believe this.
Yeah?
All throughout Ninewood Hills, I have staked out some windways.
Windways?
Steak! Now that you mention it, I'm starving. Have you got anything else tasty on the menu?
Oh, sure. Here you are. Might I recommend today's special, the Sahagin soup?
Stop that! We'll never get to the point if you egg them on like that!
Huh? You want eggs?
Oh, fried? Sunny side up?
All we've got is scrambled.
Just tell us about the windways!
Oh, those? They're basically just shortcuts. The kids call it fast travel. You get to zip around every which way using one of those gooey doohickeys. Yep.
I don't think you're allowed to go there.
So what if the food's a little gooey? I'll still eat it.
We are not talking about food!
Oh. Wait, I get it. All that business about steak, that was a pun. Nice one, Lon.
Oh, thank you.
Don't tell me you thought he was serious!
I realized something just now. We can never leave Lon and Seraphie alone together.
Nothing good could come of it.
Press square anywhere. Ninewood Hills to open a list of shortcuts. You can use the windways to quickly warp around town. Cool. A place I can't access. Still no minigames.
What's up, Rain?
Baguettes. I think that's it for this episode. Part one of Jay Plays World of Final Fantasy. I'm gonna take a break. I'll be back on later. Or if you're not watching the stream live and you're just watching the videos, part two will come at some point following part one. Thank you for watching.